The WorkOS team just made some great new resources for Remix developers. In this video, we'll take a look at AuthKit Remix and perform the minimum number of steps to get AuthKit working inside of a Remix app. Let's get into it. On screen, we have the WorkOS AuthKit repo on the left and a freshly generated Remix app on the right. Jump to the installation instructions and add the package WorkOS Inc. AuthKit Remix. Next, create a new env file. We'll use .env.local and copy these required variables from this code snippet. To get the required client ID and API key, we need to visit the WorkOS dashboard where we'll find both. Copy, and paste both the client ID and the API key. While we're here, copy this redirect URI and in the WorkOS dashboard, navigate to redirects. Here, we'll ensure that this URL is in the redirects list, which it is, and also set up as the homepage URL. This URL is wherever you want to redirect users once they've signed out. Back to our instructions, the last thing that we need to do is generate a cookie password, either using the one password generator or this open SSL command. And we're done with the configuration. Next thing we need to do is add the loaders, actions, and templates that we're going to use inside of our Remix app. Down in setup, copy the code for the auth loader and create a new file that matches the route in your redirect URI. In this case, we'll be in app routes and create a new file called callback.ts. This simply imports the auth loader from WorkOS Inc. AuthKit Remix and makes that available at this callback route. Finally, we need to add a view, actions, and loader on the route. So let's copy this page and replace what's in our app routes underscore index. There's a good amount of code here, so let's step through it. First, we have some pretty standard Remix imports, followed by our AuthKit Remix imports, get sign in URL, get sign up URL with auth, and sign out. We then export an async loader function and call with auth on the request to get our user. We then pass along with sign in URL and sign up URL as JSON. To sign out, we have an action that simply awaits sign out with the request. Finally, we have our page where we accept the user sign in URL and sign up URL from user loader data. And if there's no user, we present them with a login and sign up link using our URLs. And when there is a user, return a form that displays the username and on submit calls the sign out action. Let's run this dev server and see it all in action. In our browser, navigate to localhost 5173, which is the Vite default. Select log in or sign up. I already have a demo account for these purposes, so we'll use that. And there we go. Welcome back, Michael. And use our sign out action to go back to the root URL. So that's it. That's really all it takes to get hosted AuthKit working inside of a Remix app. If you'd like to see a more production representative example of how to integrate AuthKit and Remix, then I recommend that you check out the Remix AuthKit example app that Paul Ash has set up. This app uses more conventional Remix patterns. It will allow you to support user authentication over a number of pages, not just one. Big shout out to Paul Ashes, who makes all of these integrations and example apps. Let us know in the comments which frameworks you'd like to see covered next. I'm Chantastic. We'll see you in the next one. Bye.